So do you want to do a formula that has three letters in it?
I yearn to.
Okay.
I may even get it right.
All right.
There's an off chance.
All right. So suppose we have a formula, A ampersand B, parentheses, horseshoe tilde C. We're going to put this on top of a table, draw the lines, and over here we're going to write the letters that are in the formula. In this case, we have an A, a B, and a C. And then underneath the letters, we're going to write all the possible truth value combinations that these three letters could have. And there's going to be eight of them. Remember that if you take 2 and raise it to the nth power, where n is the number of letters in your formula. We've got quite a few dogs around here. Well, it's got some dog action. You take 2 and raise it to the nth power, where n is the number of letters in your formula, then that will tell you how many rows your table will have. So this table is going to have 2 to the third rows, because there's 3 letters, and that's 8 rows. And if you do it this way, you'll get all the possible truth value combinations for the 3 letters. Start at the top and go true, 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 4 T's. And now go 4 F's to make 8 rows. Now under the B, we go 2 trues, and then 2 F's, 2 trues, and then 2 F's, and a buzzer. And then finally under the C, we alternate TF all the way down. TF, TF, T, TF. It's a lot of T's and F's.
A lot of T's and F's.
And what's the main connective?
Maybe the horseshoe.
Why?
It's got biggest scope. This one's got a small one. That one's got one a little bigger, but that one has this entire thing as its antecedent, this entire thing as a consequent.
So smallest scope, next biggest, biggest.
Yeah, this ranges over the entire statement.
Mm-hmm. So the main connective is the horseshoe, so the final column is going to be the values underneath the C, which Mark's going to neatly line up under the C.
Maybe.
And then that'll tell us, when we look at the final column, the logical status of the formula, whether it's tautological, contingent, or contradictory. So do you want to fill this in?
Sure. I'll take a crack at it from this side, just being right-handed. I'm just going to go horizontally again this time. In row 1, A is true, B is true, and C is true. We'll start off with the connective with the smallest scope. If C is true, that'll be false. Next one, if we have true, true, that'll make for 2 ampersand. And if we have a true antecedent and a false consequent, that gives us a false conditional. So one way you make a conditional false is if you have a true antecedent and a false consequent. Row 2, rather briskly here, A is true, B is true, and C is false. I'm just copying these guys here. Now I'm filling in the rest of the blanks. The tilde here is going to be true, the opposite of that. The ampersand is going to be true, and then the conditional is going to be true. Row 3, A is true, B is false, and C is true. If C is true, the tilde is false. The ampersand here is going to be false, because it's the only way you make an ampersand true is if both sides are true. And now to do the horseshoe, I look at the main operator on the left side, the main operator on the right side, and that's going to give me a true horseshoe. That was a long one. Okay, A is true, B is false, and C is false. Tilde is going to be true, ampersand is going to be false, horseshoe is going to be true. A is false, B is true, C is true, that'll be false, this will be false, conditional is going to be true once again. A is false, B is true, C is false, tilde will be the opposite of that. This ampersand is going to be false, the conditional is going to be true. False, false, true, false, false, gives me true. And then finally, A, B, and C are all false. So the tilde will be true, the ampersand here will be false, and the main connective there, the horseshoe, is going to be true. So here's the final column. We have at least one false and at least one true, and that's going to tell me this is a contingent statement. If it was all trues, it'd be a tautology or tautologous. If they were all falses, it'd be a contradiction. But if you have at least one F, at least one true, it's a contingency. I'd actually be able to know that just by looking at the first two rows. I did a complete truth table because that's what we're wanting to demonstrate here. But as soon as I know one of the main connectives is false and one's true, that would be enough to let me know actually it's a contingent statement. But we may want to do the complete truth table depending on what your instructor is asking you to do. So we have a contingency.